This video will introduce you to Qlik's new authoring experience, which accelerates application creation for all, regardless of skill or experience level. When you enter edit mode, you have access to the new standard options UI. You can switch to the advanced options by toggling on the option from the top right corner. On the left side, you have the field panel and master items. Also, you have the Properties panel with suggestions of data fields, visualization types, and presentation options. At the bottom, you have a data table as well as buttons for quick creation of new charts. In the Fields panel, you have all the different field types such as geographical fields, numerical fields, and string fields. You can expand them to see individual values of that dimension as well as a frequency counter. You can make selections directly in the Fields panel while still in edit mode. As you make selections, you can see that these get added to the Selections bar. If you choose to collapse the section, it is still clear that you have made selections in this area. From the Fields panel, you can still access a number of different settings from each of these categories. The data table at the bottom helps you to investigate and look at the data. You can do sorting in it, and you can also make selections inside the data table. The data table helps you quickly get an overview of the data. If you have several tables, you can switch between them using this drop-down menu. You have multiple options to explore and to build up your app. Let's start creating our first visualization. Select a field from the list and drag it to the Data Properties panel or into the chart. You can decide whether you want to drop it in as a dimension or as a measure, or if you want to let the Qlik Cognitive Engine decide for you. In this case, we choose to get a suggestion and use the Auto Chart functionality. It immediately returns a table. You can continue building your visualization by dragging a measure onto it. It will automatically pick a different and more suitable representation. Or it will suggest a chart that would look good using one dimension and one measure. You can add additional fields to the chart, and from there you will get other types of suggestions. You can also override the auto chart feature by picking a visualization directly from the panel. The filter selection allows you to filter one specific chart. Normally, set analysis would have been required to create this filtering. But here you can simply drag and drop the field and get a suggestion for what you want to do with it. When you make this selection, you will see that in the footnote of the chart, there will be an indicator that a filter has been applied in order to avoid confusing the user. There are also other types of filtering that can be used. You can filter based on a search. You can filter based on a condition. You can also clear the selection. This can be used if you want a chart that ignores selections made in a field in other charts. You can create new visualizations by adding dimensions and measures to a new item. In this case, we add month-year as a dimension and sales as a measure. The Qlik Cognitive Engine will automatically create a line chart. By clicking the plus icon, you can quickly create a new object that you can use to create any type of visualization. In this way, you can quickly build up your dashboard. Also, you have the option to switch off the data table if you don't want to see it while you are creating visualizations, and then restore it if you need it. And if you want to come back to the classic experience, you can toggle on the advanced mode options to customize the visualization you have created. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.